Point, isn't it? Now, two margin of the valve is okay. So the fixed margin and the free margin. Free margin is the irregular margin or serrated margin, the like serrated teeth like, isn't it? So they are the serrated. So two margin, fixed margin attached to the fibrous ring of the atrial ventricular valve, and next there is the free margin. They are the serrated margin. Now, what is the important in the serrated margin? I will tell. Okay, after explaining the surface. Okay. Now we'll see the surface of the cusp. Okay. If we see the surface of the cusp, there are two surfaces. Okay, one surface facing towards the atrium, one surface faces towards the ventricle. So the name of two surfaces, they are the ventricular surface and the atrial surface. Okay, so the two surfaces of the cusp. So the two surfaces of the cusp, they are the atrial surface, and next one is the so see here, this surface while closing it will face to the atrium. So this surface, okay, this is the atrial surface that face towards the atrium, and next surface, see, this is the atrial surface, okay, and this surface, see, this surface that face towards the ventricle. So your ventricle is here. Okay, I'll draw here. Suppose this is the ventricle is here. Okay, here is the atrium. So see this surface, this is the ventricular surface that face towards the ventricle, and this is the atrial surface, that surface face towards the atrium. And if you see the difference in the surface, atrial surface are smooth surface and ventricular surface, they are irregular surface. Just remember these two things. Okay, so this is about the structure of the cusp. Okay, structurally made up of two layer of endothelium, and in between the two layer there is the fibrous tissue. And if you see the parts of this cusp, you will find the two borders and the two surfaces. Two border, fixed border. One border is the fixed, one is the free border, serrated border, irregular border. And two surface, atrial surface that is the smooth surface, and the ventricular surface that is the irregular surface or rough surface. Just remember up to here. Now the next component of the valve, that is the support of the valve. Okay, see, there is support is there from the valve. There is the extension of some cord like extension. Can you see this? So they are the, what is the name of that?
Corda tendine.
Corda tendine. So the supports of the valve is formed by the corda tendine and the papillary muscle. Okay, this corda tendine you can write. Okay, supports of the. So supports of the valve. Okay, so see, two margin were there and two surfaces were there, isn't it? So the corda tendine is attached to the free irregular border margin and also to the ventricular surface. So the corda tendine is attached to the ventricular surface of the cusp and also to the free margin of the or free irregular or free serrated border of the cusp of the valve. Okay, and finally this corda tendine extend up to the apex of the papillary muscle. Okay, tendineous cord. Okay, so the tendineous cord, it extend between the apex of the papillary muscles and the free margin of the valve and also to the ventricular surface of the valve. Just you remember up to here. Then the main intention of the support is to prevent the valve from collapsing. That means to keep the valve patent. Okay. So the finally the function of the valve. What is the function of the valve? What is the function of the valve? To maintain the unidirectional blood flow and to prevent the regurgitation of the blood. That I have already mentioned. So this is the structure of the atrioventricular valve. Okay, up to here. Okay, now see, so they are the basic structure. In case of both right and left, similar structures are there, similar component are there in valve. Now only the difference is in the cusp. Okay, now we'll see the tricuspid and bicuspid here. So tricuspid valve. So see, only the difference, structure is same, structure of valve is same. They have got a base, they have got a cusp, they have got a support, same. But only the difference is the number of cusps here. So there are three cusps. So, and each cusp has got a border surface same, okay. So the three cusps, the name of the three cusps, that is, what is the name of the three cusps here? So anterior, posterior are, next name for posterior is inferior, and next is the, okay, the next name for posterior is inferior, okay. For your easiness, just you remember anterior, posterior and septum. It will be easy, okay, to remember. So this anterior, posterior and septum, they are attached to the apex of anterior, posterior and septal papillary muscle, okay. In case of bicuspid, only two cusps are there. So the name of two cusps, they are anterior and posterior. So this anterior and posterior, they are attached to the anterior and posterior papillary muscles, okay. Just you remember here. So each cusp are attached to the two papillary muscles, okay. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Cusp attached to okay. Now see, if you see the difference in the shape and size of the cusp, if you compare the cusp of the tricuspid with the cusp of the bicuspid, comparatively the cusp of bicuspid is smaller and thicker. Okay. Smaller but thicker. Okay. Just you remember these two things. Okay. And in tricuspid valve, you can insert your three finger. Okay. So it has got a space to insert the three finger. You can insert the three finger from that valve. But in bicuspid only, you can insert the two finger. Okay, just remember. Okay, are you getting? So this is the difference in the tricuspid and bicuspid. Almost all structure, it is similar. Okay, only there is the difference in the number of cusps. So the next name for the bicuspid, that is the mitral valve, just you remember. Okay, up to here. So this is about the atrial ventricular valve. Now we'll go for the semilunar valve. See, and see, one more thing, see this atrial ventricular valve, they closes during the this valve closes during the ventricular systole or ventricular systolic, okay, during the contraction of ventricle. Are you getting? You know about this thing? So AV valve, both tricuspid and bicuspid, closes the ventricular systole or ventricular systole. Okay, means during the contraction of ventricle, that means, okay. Contraction of means both ventricle, okay, right and left, okay. I'm telling about the both. So see, always see the opening valve. While opening the opening of valve does not produce any sound, okay. But the while closing of the valve, the sound is produced. So see, the first heart sound is produced by the closure of atrioventricular valve, okay. So, first you have read this thing in feeling the closure of atrioventricular valve. So, during the closure of atrioventricular valve, the first heart sound is heart, okay, and the second heart sound is heart during the closure of semilunar valve. Just remember this thing, okay. So, same contract. Are you getting this? Thus you remember this thing. So first heart sound is, you can hear the first heart sound when there is the closure of atrio ventricular valve. That is the lab. Lab, the heart sound is there. The lab is the first and dub is the second. Okay. So this is about the atrio ventricular valve. Now next is the semilunar valve. See here, closing and opening you can see. And this closing of the valve, see here, when the papillary muscle contract, the valve will close. When the papillary muscles is relaxed, the valve is open. Okay, just you remember this thing here. So this is the phenomenon you can see in the moving diagram here. Okay, this is the closing, opening. See, while closing, see, ventricle is contract. Ventricle is contracting, isn't it? See, while opening, ventricle is relaxed. This contraction of this ventricle, this is the ventricular systole. Okay, so while ventricular systole is there, the AV valve is closed. And while ventricle relax or atrium contract, they will open. Okay, now next we go for the next. That is the semilunar valve. Okay, this much is sufficient for you. Now next is the semilunar valve. Now see, there are two semilunar valves. Okay. So the semilunar valve, it lies between the ventricle and the two great artery actually. Okay. So the function is same. They maintain the unidirectional blood flow and they prevent the regurgitation. The function is same. Okay. Now see, we have got the two semilunar valve, pulmonary valve, and next one is the aortic valve. Okay, so two semilunar valve. This pulmonary valve, it lies in the pulmonary orifice. That orifice lie between the right ventricle and the pulmonary trunk. Whereas the aortic valve, that lies in the aortic orifice, and this aortic orifice lies between the left ventricle and the ascending aorta. You know these things. See here, you see in this diagram here. See, right atrium is here. Right ventricle is here. Here this is the pulmonary trunk. So here see, right ventricle open into the pulmonary opening here. So this opening is guarded by some valves. Okay, there are three cusps in this valve. They are the semilunar valve. So this is the pulmonary valve. So pulmonary valve in between the right ventricle and the pulmonary trunk. Similarly, aortic valve in between the left ventricle and the aorta, ascending aorta. So here you can see the structure of the semilunar valves. See here you can see the three cusps. Okay, both this pulmonary valve and aortic valve, they have got the three cusps here. Okay, so they are the basic structure. You will see the cusps here. Three cusps are here. So here you can see the pocket here, or cup like pocket formed by this valve here. So these are the free margin here. Okay, so this valve, see, this valve closed during the ventricular diastole, means while relaxation of ventricle. Okay, this valve will close during the ventricular diastole, but atrioventricular valve closed during the ventricular systole. Okay, thus you have to remember this thing. So see here, this is the basic structure you can see here. Now we'll see the structure. Oh, structurally both valves are similar. Okay, so they have got a three cusps. Okay, they have got a three cusps. Now if you see the cusp here, see. So this cusp, they are made by the endocardial fold only. Okay, fold, and within which there is the fibrous tissue. The structure is same. The cusp of the valve, structurally they are same. So three cusps. One cusp is this. One cusp is this. One cusp is this. Now see this. Each cusp, they are attached to the wall of the vessels. Okay, see here. Just I have cut this and opened it. And see here, there are three cusps, and these each cusp, they are attached to the wall of the vessels only. In case of in the pulmonary vein valve, they are attached to the wall of pulmonary vein, pulmonary artery, and aortic valve, they are attached to the wall of aorta. Okay, so the each cusp is attached to the wall of the vessels. That is, pulmonary is attached to the pulmonary valve attached to the pulmonary trunk, and the aortic valve is attached to the aorta, ascending aorta. So you remember that. And see this, the cusps of the valve, they forms the cup. Can you see here? Cup here. So see, this is the cup. So this cup, okay. So this cup, that faces away from the ventricle. See, this is the ventricle, the part of ventricle is here, and this is the aorta or vessel here. If this is the, see, actually this is the aortic wall, because it has got a opening of coronary artery. Okay, so this is the actually aortic wall. So this is the left ventricle is here, this is the aorta is here. So this cusp face towards the aorta, the opening of the cusp. See, this is facing towards the aorta, means this is facing away from the ventricle. Thus you have to remember this thing also. So each cusp is attached to the wall of the vessels, and they forms the cusp or cup like. See here, you can see here cup, bowl like. See, this is the wall is like this. See, they forms a pocket, isn't it? See my hand here. So this hand is the cusp of the wall. This is the wall of the vessels. See here, you can see the pocket here, pouch here, in between the wall and the cusp. So cups are pockets formed by the attachment of the cusp of the each valve, cusp of the each valve with the wall of. So the cusp or pocket are formed by the attachment of the cusp of the wall with the wall of the vessel. See this. See, can you see here? See here. This is the wall is here, and cusp of the wall is here, and they forms the pocket here. Okay. So they are the pocket. So this pocket, if you see the mouth of the pocket, opening of the pocket, the opening of the pocket is facing away from the ventricle. Okay. Ventricle is here. This is facing away from the ventricle. Then what will happen? See, during the contraction of the ventricle, what will happen? This valve is open. They will open here, so the blood will go out. And while the ventricle is relaxing, means while that is the ventricular diastolic phase, while relaxing means they have to open now. While opening, what will happen? The blood which was going outside, they will fill up this pocket here. Okay. So ventricular contraction was there, blood will go out. Then while relaxing, it will suck the blood. Then what will happen? This blood will suck back, and they will fill this pocket. And by filling this pocket, then what will happen? This all the valve, they will approximate each other here. See here, they will come closer to each other, and they will close. So while during the ventricular systole, they will close up due to the filling of blood in this pocket. Okay. Just remember up here. Now see here. Now you see the free margin of cusp here. Okay, in the free margin, in the center, you will find the some nodule here. So this is the nodule. Okay, this is the fibrous tissue. Okay, so this is the free margin. At the center of the free margin, you will see the. So center of the free margin, you will see the. So this nodule, this is actually the fibrous tissue only. And free away from the this nodule, see, this is the smooth margin. The smooth margin of the semilunar valve is known as lunule. Okay, smooth margin, that is L-U-N-U-L-E, lunule. So the smooth portion of the free margin, that is the lunule, and this is the nodular like fibrous mass in the center, that is the nodule. Thus you remember that. Okay, now one more thing you have to know about this semilunar valve, that is the sinus. Okay, this sinus, that is actually formed by the dilatation of the vessels valve along the site of attachment of the cusp. So this, see, this is the wall of the vessels, and there is the attachment of the cusp. And what will happen? See, at the site of attachment of the cusp, this wall is dilated here. Okay. Or bulge out, or dilated. So this portion of this wall of the vessels, that is the sinus. Okay. So this is the dilated part of the vessel at the site of attachment of the cusp of the semilunar. Sublunar valve. Okay. So this portion is the sinus of the valve. Now this is the basic structure of semilunar valve. Okay. Now we'll see the in each valve, that is the aortic and the pulmonary valve. Now only few things are different here. Okay. Only the name of cusp is different, and there is slightly difference in the sinus also. Now we'll see the pulmonary. Pulmonary valve, and next is the. Now see the number of cusps in each valve, pulmonary and aortic valve. The number of cusps is same, 3 are there. Okay. Now in case of pulmonary valve, the name of cusp is right cusp, left cusp, and anterior cusp. Just remember this thing. And in case of aortic valve, the name of cusp is, just remember, right, left, and right cusp, left cusp, and posterior cusp. Now see, some book there is the difference in the naming of the cusp. Okay, in case of aortic valve, see here, in some book they have got a name anterior, posterior, and left posterior. So see, this anterior and this left posterior, that is anterior is right, left is the left posterior. Okay, that is the same thing, only the naming is different. Okay, in different book. Okay, are you getting up to here? See, this right, left, and posterior, it is easy to remember for you also. Okay, for pulmonary, right, left, and anterior. So while remembering, it will be easy. Otherwise, you can remember anterior, posterior, and left posterior. Okay. Are you getting?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Just I'll write here. Post. Okay. Now see here. Now what is the difference? Now see, the sinus of this pump, the pocket, they have got a name. Now they are the pulmonary sinus. Okay, what is name of sinus? So the name of cusp is, see this is the cusp, the cusp of the valve. They have got a aortic valve, so this is the left, right, and posterior. The name of cusp is like that. Now sinus is there, pocket is there, pouch is there. This pouch has also got a name. So in case of pulmonary valve, see. So right cusp includes the right sinus, left sinus, anterior. So name of sinus is also right, left, and anterior. Okay. Now in case of aortic, the name is also same. So right, left, and posterior. If you are telling right, left, and posterior cusp, then the name of sinus is right, left, and posterior. If you are telling anterior, left, posterior, and posterior, the name of sinus is also anterior, left, posterior, and posterior. Okay. Okay, so they are the name of cusp. So cusp, name of cusp is right, left, and anterior. The name of sinus is also similar to that, the name of cusp. Are you getting up here? Now one more thing in case of aortic valve. Okay, so sinus is also, it has got a name similar to that of cusp. Now here one more thing is there, that is a coronary sinus. Okay, so here coronary sinus, see this sinus of the aortic sinus. So this aortic sinus, okay, so this aortic sinus, it has got a name. So right, left, and posterior, this is the sinus, that is the pulmonary sinus. Okay, now see this aortic sinus, see, out of these three aortic sinus, the two aortic sinus has got a name coronary sinus. Okay, because why? See, can you see here? This is the actually structure of aortic valve. Now see here, they are the aortic sinus. Now see, in this, out of the three aortic sinus, there is the opening. Two openings are there. Only in the openings are there in two coronary sinus. See, two aortic sinus. See, they are the opening of coronary artery actually. So we have got a two coronary artery, right and left coronary artery. See, this right and left coronary artery begin from the two aortic sinuses. Okay, so these two sinuses where there is a opening of coronary artery is there, they are named as the coronary sinus. Are you getting? So these two coronary sinus are right and left. So in the right coronary, sorry, in right aortic sinus, there is the opening of right coronary artery. In the left coronary, lower left aortic sinus, there is the opening of left coronary artery. So these two sinus is named as coronary sinus also. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So these two sinus is coronary sinus, but you will not see this opening in the this pulmonary sinus. Okay. So two coronary artery, right and left coronary artery will opening. Okay, opening or beginning actually. This is the beginning of right and left coronary artery. So this two aortic, that these two aortic sinus, they have got a name coronary sinus also. If you name the aortic sinus right, left, and posterior, right and left are the in the right and left, there is the beginning of coronary artery.
Some if you name the class.
Coronary sinus anterior, okay. If you name the aortic sinus anterior and left posterior and posterior, then anterior and left posterior, this is the coronary sinus. So from the anterior, there is the beginning of right coronary artery. From the left posterior, there is the beginning of left posterior, left coronary artery. If you name the right and left, there in the right beginning of right coronary, in the left, there is the beginning of left. If you name anterior, left posterior, then from the left posterior aortic sinus, there is the beginning of left coronary artery. Just I'll write here for you. So anterior coronary sinus. So beginning of right coronary artery. And from the left posterior aortic sinus, so there is the beginning of left coronary artery. And posteriorly, there is no beginning of any artery. So these two, they are also named as coronary sinus. So this is about the wall of the heart. Now see, one more thing I will tell and I will leave you. Now, see, these are the semilunar valve. This semilunar valve closes during the ventricular diastole. So during the closure of the semilunar valve, you will listen the second heart sound, that is the dub. Lub dub is there. Lub is the first heart sound and the dub is the second heart sound. So the second heart sound is, you will hear the second heart sound during the closure of semilunar valve, means during the closure of this both valve, okay, aortic and the pulmonary valve. And this valve will close during the ventricular
diastole.
Okay, thus you have to remember, that means ventricular relaxation. During contraction they will open, but during relaxation they will close. But semilunar valve, during contraction semilunar valve, sorry, but atrioventricular valve, during contraction of ventricle, atrioventricular valve, they will close, but semilunar valve will open. During relaxation of the ventricle, atrioventricular valve open and this semilunar valve, they will close like that. Okay, just one moving picture is there, just you see here. Okay, can you see here, see this opening and closing? So this is the about the semilunar valve. Now I will continue remaining in next class. Thank you, class.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.